So they'll bring their cans and they go, we're just going to stack these up. And then if they buy cans with two lips on them, they're going to get to the third layer and go, this doesn't work, right? So we've got to think of something else. That happened to us one year where we actually ordered cans that were color specific, but didn't realize that they weren't stacking. So I said to my order guy, I'm going, are you serious right now? So the night before, no.
That day,
they all got delivered. So then I got one guy, all he's doing all day is cutting saucers. Because now I need that to sit in there to create that. So that's the emergency fix to two male ends, if you will. Or female ends on the can. Is that you need something in between to keep the two together. So that's just a really simple cardboard fix to make those two go together. Then if you stack up cans probably more than three high, if you want to create the crayon stack, after you get three high, it's going to start getting tippy. At any rate, it's going to start to get tippy. So then what we do is we just put in a simple cardboard shim, and then you can just keep stacking. Because it'll just level everything out and it gives you a new base and you can keep going. And then of course we cut them thin enough so that the can sticks over a quarter inch and that you really can't see it. And then if you really want to get fancy, when we did our R2D2, we did them all in plywood and then we sprayed them silver so you really couldn't see them. So we really got stealthy with it. You are allowed to use clear tape, but you're not allowed to destroy the label. So if you wanted to put these two cans together, because your stack is getting too high, then you can take them. So it is permissible to take them together, because you have to be able to return these cans with the label not damaged, and that they can see what they're getting. So once you tape these together, they become super rigid, right? But then when you go to deconstruct your model, you have to bring a knife and you have to slice it. You can't tear it off.
So is there a day for deconstruction then, too?
Yeah. And it's March 29th. So then, of course, you can use wire, you can use rope, you can use Velcro. We can never use Velcro. I don't imagine how. This kind of thing, but it would be a pretty expensive model. Rope we used on that one, so obviously you're not going to tie it to a can, but when we put the plywood plates on, we just drill holes and then run the rope up inside there and tape them on or glue them on, and then the rope will act to make the model more rigid. And then another method that we use, because we built one model that we needed curved cans, we needed to arc them. Janice, you've got to help me with this. So this is removable magic. So you can use removable magic to do things temporary, and then it won't ruin the label. So then you've got a stacked can, and then it's flexible, so you can create an arc. So one of the models on Pinterest, they built a slinky, and this was how they would have done it. So they can create an arc, and they can get these cans to stay curved, and you're not breaking any rules by doing this either. Super rigid. Okay, and then the other thing that we've done with duct tape, that I'll just show you with magic tape today, is you can tape all the tops together if you get a can stack that's really tall. Thank you. you don't want to use cardboard here, then we've used tape on these two edges as well. So you just take, like I say, duct tape works better than magic tape, but you just tape these two corners together and burnish it down with your fingernail, and then you can just keep going with more cans, and then that two kept those two together. And you can just tape the whole wall together like that if you've got an arc or whatever. One year, we did work with cans intentionally. I think when we did the City Hall and the bean cans, they were all cans that had a double lip on them, and we stacked them staggered. So most of the time, the models that you see, if we were talking bricklaying terms, you talk stack bond. So this is a stack bond when you lay bricks. But if your cans are all the same color and you want to do something round or even linear, you can go to stack bond, or sorry, running bond. So this would be a running bond in bricklaying, and then of course they work, right? Because they're staggered, all the lips are staggered. But you usually get into trouble on the end, because when you go like this, you can make a square stack, square end on your model. You do this, you've got a, unless it's round, you've always got these tapered ends on your model, which creates a headache aesthetic. So anyway, that's a pretty short presentation, but there's just not a lot of different ways to stick these cans together. That's just how we do it. So.
Don't worry, Selena.
Okay, just imagining at like 4 o'clock at night, we're just like turning around to walk away and it all falls down. Has that ever happened?
Well, our spaceship model, if you were here,
oh, yeah.
The spaceship one, yeah, we lost our launch tower 3 or 4 days in because our tape fatigued. So we told them it was intentional, but they didn't believe us. I don't think we've had anything come crashing down. But, because you pretty well know it, like as you're building it, whether it's getting precarious or not, right? And so there's a lot of us there that are skilled. And so for the junior teams, like, we don't mind jumping in and helping you. If we got extra, we're going over the top this year. Our team, our model's over $5,000. So we have 5,400 cans. We're building some cathedral out of Russia. So my team's going to be pretty busy. I'm only allowed 5 people in, and I got to do it in. So we're really going, but that's our job. We're they go to be chairman now, so I got to blow doors on all of them. So that's what we're doing. We're going to try really hard to push the game. But we'll help them. You know what I'm saying? So I'll have extra team members, whatever, there that have done it before, and so I say, hey, you know what? Run down and help them. At least teach the principles while we're there, right? So that we can help just put it together. Are you guys still planning to put your models together beforehand and then come rebuild?
Not necessarily the whole thing.
Right. Okay.
But they are going to start practice like different.
They sure should start to do that. Exactly.
That's our biggest issue right now is semester break. Christmas break. So
January 15th. So that we have to review the designs. And you know, I work most nights, so if it's a little late I can make it work. But we did have to have some kind of deadline so that, you know, I'm a little easier going than Judy and Tara. You know, the boat races. We really want you guys entering, so we'll be gracious.
Does that need to be in SketchUp or a specific program?
It just has to be recognizable. So we do ours all in Google 3D, or Google SketchUp, right?
SketchUp,
yeah. So that's how we do ours. It's just super easy to work with and change or whatever. I can't imagine drawing it by hand. Our early models were 2D, but still done in AutoCAD. Because it's so highly repetitive, you just right as far as opposed to drawing it by hand. But yeah, we'll accept it as long as I can see what it is.
And when would you need our CAN orders back that same day? So we could order it through some office?
No, the CAN orders are 15 days before build, so it's February 15th. So we want to look at it, and that's almost non-negotiable. Because 1 year, all of our trucks got stuck in a snowstorm. So we were limited on our cans. We were running Safeway, West Side. We were going all over town buying more food because we needed like 150 or 200 cans of a certain thing, which you know they just don't stock that, right? But it's half the fun. It's just there's stuff that goes wrong every year. It's pretty entertaining. So.
You do have medals for the 3 medals for the youth team, most creative, best meal, and student's choice. meal.
Sure, so best meal, you know, when we did our model of City Hall, it needed to be brown and black, so it was solid beans. Well, we didn't win best meal. It was a pretty monolithic model. So the water tower, on the other hand, I don't think we won best meal, but you can see with all the different colors of the cans, we had a lot of variety in here, so fruits and vegetables and meats, and so they're going to look at that, right? So you can actually have the worst structure there aesthetically, but you could still win best meal because you put enough stuff in there that we could actually build an entire meal out of your...
If we get a sponsor, we can advertise them?
Yes, so each station gets a poster. And you can design your poster the way you want. So if you got someone that gave you $500 and then a bunch of people that gave you $100, you can arrange them in the size that you want. You'll not be in our advertising as far as pushing can structure. So you'll see us, I think we're getting into the Lethbridge Living, but Lethbridge Herald will be on radio and all those kinds of things. And so Associated Engineering, who is the sponsor of the entire event, their name will be mentioned in some of that stuff. But not all the people that give to all the teams, you can imagine it's a lot. But they will have their name on a nice big poster at the model for 30 days in the hall, so they will be recognized.
So will we have like a FOIT form and a form to fill out through our career transition?
Yes, yeah, we will.
Just like full races?
Yes. Yes.
So question, for the design, they can put like construction paper over it if they're wanting like certain colors, rather than like if some cans are more expensive, let's say they really want like an orange label, they can print off like construction paper and cover the can?
That's exactly right.
Okay.
So I explained last meeting, we had a team last year do Canada's 150th birthday. They ordered all these red cans. Between the order time and the, or maybe their decision time, and the when they were buying their can to do their model, the company had changed the label. So they get all blue cans, right? And going, oh crap. So they had to wrap each one of their cans in streamers. And so it was acceptable because we knew it was a crisis. So we wouldn't want you to do that all your cans. But if you're building, if you're building a pumpkin, we want you to use orange cans. But if you're building something where you just need some punctuation of a different color or whatever, certainly we let you do that.
Is there a limit to the extras? For example, there's like the peanut sky. I don't know where you went, or like you had a Muppets example last time, like because this says. That's not cans, right?
No, that's so, exactly.
Like
those are cutouts.
Hands.
And we've done those before too.
So
no problem at all.
Okay, so it just has to like in fitting with your design.
Yes, so his hands are gloves, but his arms are cans.
Yes,
so
yes.
that would be all probably wrapped in cellophane, those, but no, absolutely.
Right.
Yep, you can do that for sure.
So it'd be like if it was too much, you would catch that in the design phase and say, no, you can't do this much.
Like I say, there's no real percentage that,
okay.
80% has to be just cans showing and 20% can be something else. We don't have those kinds of restrictions, so I think it's pretty lean.
Okay. You said before you taped or glued some things on, like hot glue gun. And you mentioned also you had plywoods and then screw holes. If we needed to, could we bring those tools there, or should all that be pre-cut? Can we have hot glue guns there? Like, what can
I don't
bring?
Think you're allowed hot glue guns. You're not allowed glue of any kind.
Okay, so just tape it down.
Tape it, that's right. So these would be rolled tape on the back of these labels,
okay.
That they would tape them on the cans with a removable tape, but you're not allowed to glue your cans together.
Okay.
Now, if you had a plywood base and you needed another piece of plywood on it to give a rigidity, you can glue the two plywood together. But you cannot have glue on any can.
But like, can we bring...
You can bring saws and
everything?
Drills and all that kind of stuff. Sure.
Yeah.
We don't have a clean that is real, so make
yeah.
a mess. Now the mall might get out. But,
the
yeah.
Hot glue
to
that
exactly
plywood.
Right. Yep.
Oh.
That's exactly right. So, yeah, but you'll find that the day goes pretty quick, depending
yes.
on the. Yeah, so we never bring, other than cardboard, we bring all our plywood pre-cut, pre-drilled, pre-everything, because it's just not a very good place to work as far as, then I guess you need power. There are outlets in the mall for the kiosks, so you have to find a place. Well,